Hi, I'm Jason Hobbs. In this video, I'm going to walk you through my six-step process to get started with RightMessage, which will allow you to organize your online marketing within 40 minutes. So, and a lot of people, you're doing a lot quicker. So the first step is you need to have an email service provider, and you're going to have to connect that to RightMessage. Typically takes about 5 minutes. And I use ConvertKit, so I'm going to show you the specifics of that, but you'll see there's a bunch of different options that you could use and connect them with RightMessage. So once you are logged into the back end of your RightMessage account, there's that gear icon up there at the top. You're going to want to click it and then click integrations and then choose whichever one, and you're going to just toggle on the right hand side by the name. So ConvertKit, I toggle that on. And within ConvertKit, I'll show you real quick, is under your account settings, you're going to find the API key and the API secret key. And these are the two things that you're going to need in order to connect RightMessage with ConvertKit. So you would copy and paste them, and you'd copy and paste them over here. So once you toggle on ConvertKit, it shows these two things. Hey, we need your API key and your API secret key. And then you just can click the connect button. Once that's done, once you click the connect button, you publish it to site and you're up and running. So, the second step is you need to connect your website with RightMessage. Now, I use WordPress, so they have a free WordPress plugin, which makes it easy, or even easier, I guess. But if you don't use WordPress specifically, it doesn't matter, because all you're gonna do is copy and paste a little snippet of code into the head of every one of your website pages, every one of your URLs that are on your website, right? And so if you're using, you know, Squarespace or Magento or whatever, you'll find it's super easy to do. So, but let me show you real quick. So I go into, when I'm logged into WordPress in the back end, I just go under plugins, click the add new, type in RightMessage as the keyword, and you'll see it shows up. I click that install now, and then you don't forget you have to activate it as well. So once it's activated, under the settings, you'll see there's a RightMessage settings, right? And so what you're going to need is your account ID. And with RightMessage, you find it by, while you're logged into your RightMessage account, in the URL at the top, here's the example, you can see that 143 blah, 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 that is the account number for that specific account. So I would just copy that and I'd paste it in where 2 is there, right? And you can deal with the default embedded widget, but don't worry about it to begin with. Just get everything, get the account ID in, hit save changes, and you're up and running. And you've taken care of the first two steps now. So number one, you connected your email service provider to RightMessage, and number two, you connected RightMessage to your website. Now we're getting into the actual marketing funnel. But before we actually go into RightMessage and set that up, you need to answer a couple of questions for yourself. And if you already have an email marketing list, then these are going to be a lot easier or quicker typically. But the first thing is you need to define the first two offers of your funnel. And so typically that's going to be the free email list or a content upgrade, and then whatever the next step is that you want people to do. You may have a more in-depth free course that you want people to sign up for, or maybe it's a paid, you know, but affordable, you know, low price course, or maybe it's a one-off purchase of an ebook, or any number of things. You know yours obviously better than I do. And if you don't have one yet, then you're going to want to define what's the next step. But the very first thing will be, typically, I've never seen anybody not use the free email list or a content upgrade as the bait for the free email list. Okay, so once you have these first two, and keep in mind, you can add all the different offers in the future that you want. You're not boxing yourself into a corner or anything. This is just to get everything started and do it immediately. And so that you have your marketing funnel actually organized. You'll see at the end that it really is completely organized, and it's thanks to RightMessage. So the next step is you have to define for yourself the first two segmentation, email segmentation questions that you are going to ask people. And I've stolen these from Brennan Dunn. He's one of the co-founders of RightMessage. And the first two questions that he likes to ask, and once again, you're not boxing yourself into a corner. You can ask as many things in the future as you want. But the first one is, who is this person that showed up at your website? If you're a veterinarian, are they a dog owner? Are they a cat owner? Do they have multiple dogs and cats? Are they a breeder? Are they, you know, a local humane society or, you know, something like that? Each of these are different points of view that are all going to be customers of that business, but they're all going to get value from them in different ways based on who they are. Right. And so for your business, you want to define, and you don't have to have every single one defined to begin with. Start with the top two or three and go from there, because you can always improve it and add to it and iterate it going forward. The next question is, what do they want from you? So going back to the vet, well, maybe they want help with some ailment that their dog or cat or, you know, whatever one of their animals is dealing with. And so that could apply to any of those. It could be a cat owner, dog owner, or a farmer, right? Any of those first three. And, you know, they would all want that from them in their own way. If the business is able to know who they are and what they want, it's going to be a lot easier for that business to not waste the time of that consumer, because they're going to connect that consumer with what they want when they want it. So once you have the two offers and the first two segmentation questions locked down for your business, now you're ready for step five. And the step five is, it's typically going to be, once again, we keep it simple. There's five or six different ways that you can show this funnel on your website. It does not have to be a tough question. For instance, if you already have an email opt-in form, that wherever that shows on your website, have this funnel show up there as well. And keep in mind, it's not a, you know, they're not going to fall down a funnel, so to speak. Like, it's just in that same piece of site real estate, those pixels or whatever, you know, you're going to have this show up. And so if you may be thinking, well, I have a pop-up. Cool, no problem. They can do it that. They can do an embedded widget where it's in the sidebar of your site, or it's, you know, in the after entry widget, or, you know, whatever. So just pick one to begin with. And typically, if you, like I said, if you have the opt-in form already, just replace it with this and you're, you know, hit the ground running. So step six is where you actually build and deploy the marketing funnel, the version one. Like I said, keep in mind, this is going to be something that you're going to iterate over time. But this first one will actually impact your business, because you're going to get better opt-in rates as far as people actually join your email list. And that's not even the biggest thing. The biggest thing is the other offers you're going to make them down the line, because you're not going to have somebody show up on as the, going back to that veterinary example, right? You're not going to have somebody come back to their website and already be a subscriber and see, you know, part of the screen real estate, so to speak, is, hey, sign up for our email list, because it's going to know, no, you're already on the email list. You, if we're going to make an offer to you, it's going to be this, you know, whatever that next step is. And you're able to have that next offer be in the context of, who is this person and what do they want from this business? You see what I'm saying? So it's going to impact your conversion rates dramatically. It obviously, it's always going to be specific to your business, but that's why if you can get it set up in the first 40 minutes of your 14-day free trial, then you can actually start to realize those, you know, what's it going to be able to do for your business, start to get an inkling, actual real results, not just an inkling. And that's powerful. And then, you know, obviously it makes it so much easier at the 14 days. Hey, it's 29 or whatever bucks a month. Rock on, right? So building and deploying the marketing funnel, this occurs in the back end of your RightMessage account. When you're logged in, you'll see up at the top, you want to click that CTAs. And once you're in there, you can click on the create a new CTA funnel and get that little dialogue that you see at the top. You'll give your funnel a name and click OK. And then it's going to take you to a blank slate. You'll see there's just that little purple but or not purple, pink, whatever. It's that little button that's just a plus sign, right? So once you click on it, that's when that flyout menu shows up. And the way that I structure it is I split it by a yes or no decision. And what that boils down to is I want to ask this person, or not ask this person, I want this the software to say, hey, is this person already a subscriber to the email list? That's the yes or no question in this instance, right? And so if they are already a subscriber, then it's not going to ask them to sign up, you know, become a subscriber. It's going to offer them the second step as far as that second offer. And if they're not, it's going to obviously ask them the first two questions, segmentation questions, and then make the offer of, you know, joining the email list. So with the decision, you can see here, you know, just click in and choose it. With ConvertKit, I choose subscriber and save it. And you'll see that that little green box there, that means that it's a yes or no question. Now, in the no column, you'll see that in the yes column, it doesn't ask them a question. It just offers the second offer in the because it already asked them these other questions. So the no thing, we're going to ask them, number one, we're going to ask a question, right? And we're going to, you can actually build the questions in this thing if you want. I like to go in under manage and segmentation and questions and go ahead and build the questions there and go ahead and under manage. There's also an offers. I go in and build the offers there and, you know, up and running in no time because I go and build it there. And then once I get in here, I'm putting the pieces together and publishing it to the site and hitting the road, right? So here is the question, the first one. And once again, we're going to add the second question. And then we're going to pinch them on the offer, which is, you know, to join the email list in this instance. And over here, I show you the yes or the yes. Blew. Just cut that. All right. So create the offer. Yeah. And so here's where this is the finished thing. So this is what we want it to do. We want it to say, hey, is this person a subscriber? Yes or no. If they're not, we want it to ask them these two questions, the who and, you know, what do they need from them? Who are they and what do they need from the business? And then we want them to make the first offer, which is the free email list. And then for the yes, we want to make the second offer. So that's the flow that you see there. And you have an organized marketing funnel. It's not huge and, you know, super complex. It can be in the future, but it's going to work immediately. So the last thing that you have to do is remember we decided step five was where do you want this to show up? And the way that you handle that is the one over there on the right, that little plus sign, you just click that to create a widget to show this CTA funnel on your actual website, right? And so like I was saying, they have the different options. They have the bar across the top of the site. They have the toaster that shows up in the bottom right, the embedded, which is typically what most people I've had, most of my clients and so forth, and just people I've kind of talked through it to help them, it's typically we start with the embedded widget, unless they specifically, like I always used a toaster or a bar or whatever, then we just replicate that. So the embedded though, either way, whichever one you choose, you're going to choose it and then give it a name and, you know, click on next. And then you're going to choose these from, you know, which way do you want it to make the offer, right? So I typically start with just the simple one. Hey, you know, it doesn't have an image or anything special. It just has that headline. It has, you know, one or two entry fields. So typically, you know, it's going to just start with just an email and then it'll have the button, you know, as far as the call to action copy on the button. So you pick one and hit, you know, create, and then it's going to take you to here. And you have, for each of these widgets, there's going to be three different tabs. And so the trigger tab, as you can see, for the embedded widget, you're going to put a little name there. And then the big thing is that number two there, that's the little div that you need to copy and paste over in your website in the widget area that you want it to show up on. If you're using WordPress, say you want it in your sidebar widget, or your after entry, you know, that shows up after the blog post, then that widget, you just, you know, copy and paste it in there. And then now you're ready to go to the second tab, which is the style. And here, I'm typically going to change the contrast color, which is the bottom one. There's four different colors there. I typically will leave the others alone and just change the contrast colors. You can see it went from the red, which is, or pink or whatever that is, to begin with. And so in this instance, I used a green that I got from the logo for this example, as far as for vital animal, right? And so I'll change that. Once you're done with that, you're ready to go to details. And details is really, there's nothing to it. Just make sure that the widget is enabled. This is also where you could delete the widget if you needed to, but you know, in the future. But make sure it's enabled, and then you're ready to close it out. And you know, now your online marketing is actually organized. So if you have any questions or whatever, put a comment on this video, or you can always email me, jason@jasonhobbsllc.com, and I'll get you an answer as soon as possible. So thanks a lot, and smash that subscribe button if you haven't already, and definitely if you know anybody else that's worried about their marketing, it's not, they don't feel it's organized, then you know, let them know about this video. I greatly appreciate it. Have a good one.